Spotlight Chicago is sponsored by UI Health.
March is Colon Cancer Awareness Month and a great time to talk about prevention and screening options for colon cancer.
And here with more on this is Dr. Keith Naylor from UI Health. Dr. Naylor, thanks for being here.
It's a pleasure to be here.
So it is Colon Cancer Awareness Month. What do we need to know about colon cancer?
So colon cancer is still one of the most common cancers for both men and women. The good news is it's very preventable, and when detected early, it's very likely that people can live a long, long time even after being diagnosed if they're treated early enough.
One of my dearest friends, who's only like 49 years old, has colon cancer right now, and he had symptoms and he kind of ignored them for a while. Can you go over what the symptoms can be like?
Sure. So most commonly, people, if they actually develop colon cancer, the first symptom someone might notice is some blood that they may pass in their stool.
Okay.
It may be visible, or there's testing that actually can detect it before it becomes visible. Things like, you know, weight loss that is unintentional, abdominal pain that's unusual for them, changing their bowel symptoms. Also anemia, or, you know, if your blood count goes down related to that bleeding, all those things could be potentially a sign of something like a colon cancer in certain situations.
So you should definitely go get screened if that is you. But also, age 45, where you should just go anyway?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. So screening is intended for people who do not have any symptoms. So it's for someone feeling completely healthy. And recently, the recommendations were decreased from 50 to 45.
Uh-huh.
That's because the average age of being diagnosed is around 65. But we found that actually over the last several years, there's an increasing number of people less than the age of 50 being diagnosed with colon cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And actually for men under the age of 50, it's the number one cause of cancer-related death. And for women, it's actually number two. So it's something that we're finding more and more now in younger people. So it's even more important that people know that the recommendations now have changed to 45 to get people in as early as possible for screening. You know, so they can make sure to prevent or at least detect a problem as early as possible.
Right. So who should go before the age of 45, though?
Right. Very good question. So anyone with a family history of colon cancer, that would be in a relative like a parent or a sibling or even sometimes distant relatives. It would be important to know when that person was diagnosed. And if they were diagnosed before the age of 60, you generally start screening 10 years before the time that they were diagnosed. And that may allow people to actually start screening before a recommendation. So if you have a family member diagnosed at 40, you could even start at the age of 30.
Wow.
And the idea is to detect and potentially even prevent colorectal cancer in someone who may have a higher risk.
I did not know that.
No. Yeah. And when we're talking about screening, are we talking about a colonoscopy?
So there are many different options for people. People should choose the option that works best for them. Colonoscopy is the most common form of screening here in the U.S., but there's also what we term as non-invasive screening, tests like a FIT test or a test that detects DNA related to cancer that would be detected in the stool. So both of those tests can be done at home, which doesn't require someone to come into the doctor or have a procedure. But if those tests are positive, then they do have to undergo a diagnostic colonoscopy in order to see whether or not there was anything related to the test being positive.
Now, Dr. Naylor, I can't tell you how many friends that I have put this off because they are so intimidated by this. I mean, when Sarah and I were talking about it, it's a bit embarrassing, you know? And then on top of that, I mean, it's like you have to drink that stuff, right? I mean, like, nobody wants to drink that stuff.
There is a liquid involved.
Right.
Yes, there are different options for preparation now. The liquid is the most common option. For those that have trouble with the liquid, they should talk to their doctor because there are other options available. I think we all become like 12-year-olds when we talk about our colons.
I know.
We have to get a little bit more comfortable.
Yes.
I can't tell you, but I can tell you, you know, we try to come in with a smile, have a good, you know, attitude towards the patient because we know people are oftentimes anxious about these things. But the important thing is it's very important for our health.
Yeah.
It's very important to prevent these kind of issues. So I think taking a day and sort of just, you know, not being too wrapped up in that idea part of it.
Bite the bullet
exactly.
and do it. Stop acting like a 12-year-old girl.
Yes. Stop whining, because the key thing is if you catch it early, it's a big percentage, right, that survives.
Exactly, exactly. And because colon cancer is developed from polyps, it can even be prevented if we can identify and remove polyps before they have a chance to develop into a cancer. So it's both for detection and for prevention. So for both of those reasons, it's important to go ahead and talk about it.
You're brilliant. Thank you so much
for
being with us.
To
learn more about getting a colon cancer screening, scan the QR code on your screen, give them a call, or visit colon.uihealth.care. Don't put it off, everybody.
So important. Thank you for being here, Dr. Naylor.